Hey everyone, welcome to this episode of the Connect series. I'm Nick. We have a very exciting topic today. We have Dan Torres here. He's a product marketing engineer on our automotive connectivity team. Thanks for joining us, Dan.
Thank you guys. Thanks for having me today here, Nick.
Sure. Yeah, and this is a really interesting topic to me. So, you know, every year at CES or in the news, we see more and more technology and wireless technology going into vehicles. That's something we can all relate to because we all pretty much drive them every day. Can you tell us about some of the emerging trends coming up for connectivity in vehicles?
Right, that's a great question. It's a buzzword for sure right now happening in automotive. There are a lot of exciting things happening and not really being just a buzzword, but really becoming a real problem that we're working towards solving. Some of the things that are happening in automotive is, how do we make the car more seamlessly integrated to the phone, for example? How can we use the phone in new ways to enable new use cases inside the car? So, for example, right now, there's a big trend happening with digital keys and being able to use the phone as a key. And so basically allowing the phone to become or replace your key fob and being able to allow the user to get into the car in a passive way, right? And then start the car in a passive way. So, and then with that also, you know, enabling personalization by knowing that you have digital profiles now and digital keys, and how do you pass those keys and how do you use those digital profiles to do customizations and personalizations of the cabins, right? I like the settings in the AC some way. I like the lights in some way. I like the power seat to be calibrated a certain way. So those kind of things can be enabled by connectivity and using the phone as the main way to basically configure your car and then get you in the car and allow you to drive your car. Okay. So that's one of the biggest trends. But other things that are happening in automotive is, how do I replace cables? Because as you go and as the industry goes, we are seeing that new sensors are being added. For autonomous vehicles, you have to have a lot of sensors to be able to predict what is happening in the road. Right. And so for that reason, that means that you have a lot of cabling happening, a lot of connections. So that is posing a real challenge. It's incrementally and exponentially growing the number of sensors that cars are needing nowadays. And for that reason, connectivity is becoming a big trend and a big topic in terms of how wireless connectivity can help to overcome some of those challenges in the future.
Okay. Yeah, it makes total sense. So I'm looking forward to the future where I can sit with my phone, the music I like comes on, sets the temp I want, starts my car. It's all very exciting. And now I know for vehicles, obviously, you're kind of in a safety critical, life critical environment there with a vehicle. So can you talk about the difference between the type of product that needs to go into an automobile versus like a Bluetooth speaker or a consumer product?
Right, that's a great question. So we're living exciting times here at the connectivity business unit because we're just about to release our next generation, our third generation of wireless SoC in the 2.4 gigahertz band. And it's basically based on our commercial grade parts. And what we do is we qualify those to meet the AES-Q100 qualification standard. Okay. And it means that you have to have a more stringent test flow to actually meet the requirements for automotive customers. So in this case, this new device, CC2640R-Q1, is able to perform from minus 40 Celsius all the way to 105 C. Compared to the commercial grade version of that device, the temperature range is only going from minus 40 to 85 C, for example, right? So extended temperature is one of those things. The other thing is we do different kind of testing. The test flow is completely different to be more challenging, and being able to mimic and simulate some of the harsh environments that these devices are gonna be put through in the life cycle of the product, in this case, the car. And so again, we do a lot of things to make sure that we put the best devices out there with the highest quality, making sure that our customers get a really great part that they can use and go on with.
Okay, yeah, so stricter testing, more tolerance to temperature, harsh environment, all of those type of things. And then any difference in package or device type, or does it look any different than the commercial?
That's a great question. we actually use automotive grade packages. So this device, CC2642R-Q1, will be pin compatible with our previous generation, CC2640R2F-Q1.
Okay.
And it's basically using what we call wearable flanks.
Yeah.
So it's a QFN package with some dentations in the landing patterns, especially on the pins, to make sure that automotive customers can actually do X-ray inspection, especially when they mount these devices on the PCB. Okay. So it's easier to detect when there's a false contact in one of the PCBs, and then they can actually double inspect that using X-rays. And if there's something wrong with it, they can actually go back to the production line and they can fix that.
Wow, interesting. That's new for me. I didn't know that's what that was used for. So you mentioned a couple of families here. I know TI connectivity is not new to the automotive business. Can you walk us through kind of where we've been and where we're going? You said there's a new part coming.
Yeah, so we're releasing our third generation of BLE SoCs for automotive. As I said, CC2642R1-Q1, it's that new device. In the previous generations, we've had in production CC2541-Q1, which was the first one that we auto-qual a few years back, and then after that one we released CC2640R2F-Q1. So again, as I said, this is the third generation of devices that we're releasing for wireless SoCs in BLE and 2.4 gigahertz type of applications. But we also have a lot of expertise and experience in automotive with our WiLink 8 products. Okay. We've been selling those devices in for infotainment systems for the last 10 years. So these WiLink products are Wi-Fi plus Bluetooth plus BLE combos that are in the most popular car brands that you can imagine for managing, again, your infotainment system, the Bluetooth connectivity, the Wi-Fi spots inside the hotspots inside the car. So again, we have tons of experience and expertise in automotive. We've been selling millions and millions and millions of devices. So we're very excited about this. Again, like I said, we're living exciting times because there are a lot of new trends in automotive, new use cases. Yeah. For example, tie pressure monitors based on BLE.
Okay.
Some other applications where you want to replace cables for wireless sensors and some other things. And so looking after alternatives to lean and CAN, which mean traditionally the preferred protocols and connectivity solutions for in-vehicle networking. As I mentioned a few seconds ago, personalization. So many other things that we can do, and so many problems we're solving when it comes down to using wireless connectivity products to replace cables and also have some sort of customization around the cabin and so on and so forth. So
okay,
very exciting times.
Yeah, agreed. And it sounds like if you drove somewhere today, you likely had a TI chip on board your vehicle when you were driving. So that's cool. And I actually got a flat a few days ago, and I got the tire pressure monitor notification saying, hey, you might want to check.
Right.
So I'm sure there was some wireless involved there.
Exactly.
Now, if we get down to the hardware specifically, can you tell me the CC2640R2F-Q1 versus the new device? What are high level? What's new? What are we getting?
Great question. A more powerful processor, 2640R2F-Q1. It's based on Cortex-M3. CC2642R1-Q1 is Cortex-M4F. More memory, so going from 128 KB of flash to 352 KB of flash. More RAM, from 20 kilobytes to 80 kilobytes. More security features and enablers. The hardware accelerator that we have in 2642R1-Q1 is actually more comprehensive, supports more encryption mechanisms. So that's in a nutshell some of the huge difference. The other thing is we support BLE 5.1 with 2642R1-Q1, and 2640R2F supports BLE 5.0.
Okay.
And so one of the things, and again, going back to your trends, is using localization as a way to find a phone with respect to the car. And so many of the phone as a key use cases are enabled by receiver signal string, RSSI signals. But now that we have BLE 5.1, now you can use direction finding using AOA, angle of arrival kind of techniques, to do triangulation in addition to trilateration with RSSI. So enabling more tools that can help customers to really more accurately locate the phone with respect to the car and inside the cabin, right? You can actually try to figure out where the phone is, if it's in the driver's seat, if it's in the passenger seat, if it's in the second row, the third row, and then based on that, again, you can do personalization. You can define who is taking over the infotainment system, who is driving the Bluetooth connectivity.
Okay. Oh, that's a cool feature. Yeah, so it sounds like, you know, more memory, more processing power. We're given the tools here to expand applications. And, you know, I sense a follow-up video coming to dive deeper into the real-time localization.
Yeah.
So, Dan, I really appreciate you coming on and kind of introducing this new part to us. Anything else as far as resources or to cover with the device?
Yeah, it's a fantastic part. We have a lot of customers going into production with that device in 2020. And so we're very excited because, like I said, we're living very interesting times in connectivity for specific automotive applications. So again, very exciting. So thanks, Nick, for having me here.
Yeah,
I appreciate
absolutely.
The time. And then, you know, thanks everyone for, you know, stay tuned.
Cool. Yeah. So I'm sure we'll see Dan again. Thank you guys for joining this episode of the Connect series. Again, the automotive space is very exciting. It's moving quick. We're at the forefront of it. So we appreciate you guys joining. As always, tune in next week. We've got more great videos coming for you. Thanks.